Bonjour à tous et bienvenue à l'IAA de Munich. Ce live va être en anglais et nous allons parler de voitures volantes. So welcome everyone to the IAA in Munich. So this is an English speaking live streaming broadcast, and we're going to talk about flying cars with Paul V and Richard Krombach, who is country manager for Germany, Austria and Switzerland. Hello, Richard. Thank you for having me.
Hey, Stephanie. Hello. How are you doing? Welcome at our booth at the Munich Auto Show, IAA, at Paul V. It says, because to cut it short, Paul V, it stands for Personal Air and Landcraft Vehicle.
Okay, so we have right behind you an interesting car for the fans of Back to the Future. This is the DeLorean, and it's actually a retrofitted one. But the future is not on this side of the LA, but on that side. And we're going to go and see that incredible engine. Richard, would you please come with me?
Yes, of course, with great pleasure. This is the future. The future is today.
So this is a flying car. Does it, well, is it just a concept or does it really fly?
It does really fly. And the only challenge we have at this moment is that it will be allowed by EASA, which controls the airspace all over Europe. It's called EASA. They control the airspace and they have to give us the final approval, which we expect in about a year from now.
But is it road legal?
It is already road legal all over Europe. Yes.
So Paul V is a Dutch company. How long has it been existing?
Exactly. It's a Dutch company. We have more than 100 employees. It was founded by Mr. Robert Dingemans, ex-Philips executive committee member. And we have more than employees, especially in the aviation industry. We have a small marketing team. And it was founded in 2008 in the Netherlands.
So let's take a look at the engine. It's really impressive. And so how many people first do you fit in this engine?
It has place for two persons, and it has a possibility for 80 liters of luggage next to about 100 liters of fuel. And it can just be normal benzene, Euro 95 or Euro 98. And therefore, you can fly around 500 kilometers, or you can drive on one tank about 1400 kilometers.
So can we take a look inside? I'm moving to show you. So you have two real seats, actually. And how fast does it drive first?
Yeah, nice question. So it has two engines, two Rotax engines, which are coming out of the aviation industry. They each have 100 horsepower. It goes around 160 kilometers per hour when driving on only one engine. Once you fly with it on two engines, it goes around 180 kilometers per hour straight from A to B. So let's say we call it door-to-door mobility. You park it just in front of your house or in your parking garage or wherever on the street. You take off, you go to the nearest fuel station where you fill it up with fuel, and then you go to the nearest airport. It can be a grass airport, and then you take off. So you convert it from drive to fly in a couple of minutes. You make a tour as a pilot in a couple of minutes, and then you take off and fly 500 kilometers on VFR. So when the weather is good, sunny, no clouds, and then we take off.
Okay, so where is the trunk? You talked about luggage. Where do you put it?
So here you see on that side, put your camera on it. This is the side where you have the possibility to fuel it up with 100 mm-hmm. liters. On the other side, there's the space for luggage, 80 liters of luggage. So let's say enough to travel for you from here, Munich to, well, where you want to go, Paris maybe, to buy some stuff and fill up your luggage compartment.
Go on a shopping spree and... Yeah, okay. And so how does it work, actually?
It's let's go to the back of the aircraft or car. So here you see, which is typical for what we call a gyroplane or a gyrocopter. So it has two major components, so to say, which is the propeller you see here on the back. Once you convert it from drive to fly, you take this out with your hand. It's all naked carbon, as you can see, so it's very light. It, the weight is less than 650 kilo. And so this you take out by hand. The mast here will go up, and then it becomes a sort of rotor of 11 meters. And then this is the propeller. So the propeller, it pushes the machine forward. We need a strip of about, let's say, 100, 150 meters to take off. And then it flies until 3,500 meter high. So you can fly over the mountains.
So you have to do it by hand?
This you have to do by hand. Why? Because everything which is automatic, hydraulic or electric, it costs a lot of weight. And we want to reduce the weight as much as possible. It's very important in aviation.
And when you're on the land after flying, then you have to push it back on in place by hand as well?
No, so a lot of the things are done by hand, but it costs you only 2-3 minutes.
Okay, so that's really easy.
Very easy.
Anyone can do it.
Anyone can do it, even me.
Even me?
You too.
So do you need a driver's license for sure, but do you need a pilot license?
Absolutely. So you need a driver's license. You see that it is not four wheels, but it is three wheels. But so you need a driver's license. But you also need a license to fly it, because we don't want accidents, of course. Security is very important for us. And that's why we have our own training academy, where we try to make people ready to become a pilot in just 6 weeks, in a sort of boot camp training, 6 weeks of 5 days per week. And this can be done in, well, a country like maybe France or Mallorca, so where the weather is good. Where you can take a rest, you know, at times, but just, yeah, in components, let's say navigation, communication, flying, aviation technology, all these components you learn to become a really safe and secure pilot and having fun, not to forget.
And are those flying lessons included in the price?
No, they are not included. No, you have some no. Are we negotiating now, Stephanie? No, it's not included. No. And the price is pretty limited, actually, because we start with delivering in about a year from now. So once we have the approval of EASA, we start delivering to our clients. And we already sold more than 60 pieces of this flying car in the Netherlands.
Really?
Yeah, really. And so we start delivering them, and we call it the Pioneer version. So only 90 pieces in the beginning, with all the extras you can imagine. They cost €499,000, depending on the country. But let's say you buy it in the Netherlands, €499,000. And then there's the next version, which doesn't have all these extras. It is S from €299,000.
Which is not exaggerated, actually.
Absolutely not. You know, a lot of people, they have sports cars like Ferrari, McLaren, Bugatti, etc. The early adopters, as we call it. And these guys have a garage full of sports cars. And then we often say, yeah, you have a nice collection of cars, but none of these cars is able to fly. You have to get your Paul V.
So who are your customers? Are they geeks or?
Well, so you have private customers, the one I just described, you know, as the early adopters who would like to, I wouldn't use the word show off to their friends and happy colleagues or something, but they would like to have something special. And this is something really unique. When you go back to history and you listen to a guy called Henry Ford, he said at that moment, it's not a question if there will be a flying car once, but when there will be a flying car. And this when, you know, is filled out today because it's there in front of you. You have made a very nice movie of it. The future is now. It's in front of you. So it's today. It's there. So you can drive and fly it today.
Do you have one in your garage?
We have a couple of these cars in our Paul V garage, so to say. We also have a prototype, which was already in the air in 2010, actually. So we've proven ourselves that we can do it. And the EASA, they really have a full trust and believe in us, because they described us as that we are a company in a mature stage.
And other countries in the world where you don't need that authorization you're waiting for in the Netherlands?
Well, you have to make a difference, you know. You have to make a difference in, we are a commercial company, so we want to produce more than one flying car. That means that we are commercial. That means that we have the same regulations to listen to and to obey on, like Boeing and Airbus, for example. So very stringent, And one thing was very important for us to develop this flying car within the existing regulation. And it's not what often is called experimental. Experimental is a completely different market.
And are you working on other fuels to replace the gasoline you're using?
Absolutely. So we are here in Munich, where you see a lot about green and energy and green energy and electricity and hydrogen. We all understand that. We are working on that as well. But two major problems of other fuel cells, for instance, like electricity, are reach, because you know you don't want to be in the air that your battery is empty, right? And two things is that the battery is very heavy at this moment. So we have to wait several years until this is solved.
Okay. Well, Richard, thanks a lot for introducing to us the Paul V. And what is the next development?
The next development, you can think of. So we are now in the market of, we call it city-to-city mobility. Two persons flying from place A to place B. We don't need roads anymore, you could almost say. But you can circumvent the traffic jams, etc. One can think of vertical takeoff in the future. One can think of other energy like electricity. One can think of a major role we will fulfill in the market of, we call it urban mobility, which is a multi-billion market as well.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm waiting for you next year to pick me up in Paris and bring me to the Riviera.
Absolutely, with great pleasure, and let's have some cocktails over there and enjoy the flight.
Okay.
Let's do that, Stephanie.
Thanks a lot, Richard.
Great. Thank you.